09, clutch number 20. This was a 9-egg clutch. And this was a double head striped albino to a double head striped albino. So when you're breeding those kind of double heads together, that's your 1 in 16 shot at the double homozygous, which would be the striped albino, which we got a little female lounging in there. There was 9 eggs in this clutch. 3 of them went bad. Actually, 1 went bad and 2 of the babies died. The babies that died were normal. Well, what we got is, got Hair Nation cranking a little bit tonight. We got 4 possible double heads. See what that ratio was. That was 3.1. 3 boys and a girl. And these guys could be double het for striped albino, het for albino, het for stripe, or nothing. Just normal. Let's get this water bowl out of here. So we got the 4 possible double hets. Then we got a little striper. This is a little boy stripe. See if I can stretch him out a little bit. There we go. This is a little male stripe, and he's 66% possible het for albino. When you breed double hets, your single homozygous that comes out is possible het for the other trait, which would be albino. Not a bad little striper. And then we got what I was shooting for. And that's the striped albino. And she's shy. See if we can, there we go. These things, I always say when I first started producing them, they look like orange sherbet. Orange sherbet ice cream. Real, real cool orange color. This one doesn't have a lot of contrast. You can see those little white flecks. There's some striping right there. That white double going down the dorsal. That would be that dark coloration right there on each side of that tan colored stripe. This isn't the best one I've produced. Really can't see the back stripe. Doesn't break out that much, but as they get older, their contrast starts to come in. Female striped albino. Try to do a little zooming in. Very, very cool. Let the striper explore a little bit. So there you have it. 09 clutch number 20. We got a striped albino. And we're out.